Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, happy Easter. This day we remember the greatest event in the history of the world, that the Father has raised his Son from the dead, and that makes all the difference for us. For Jesus has destroyed the power of sin and death, and he invites us to live in that new reality. And so, my brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
You were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day, and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thank you. day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The Lord's right hand has struck with power. The Lord's right hand is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Holly, 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 luya. Holly, 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 luya. Holly, 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 luya. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Holly, 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 luya. Holly, 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 luya. Holly, 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 luya. Now Christ is raised up from death, he will never die again. All who follow his way shall have life in him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
So happy Easter. Again, we want to welcome all those who join us to prayer on this most important morning, especially the members of our congregations in Winneconne and Amro and Manawa and Waiowiga, the Sisters of the Sorrowful Mother, and our parishioners here at St. Raphael. The Lord is risen. And his resurrection makes all the difference in our world. God does not abandon us, even in death. The Father raised Jesus from the dead and so destroyed the power of sin and death. In the Old Testament, God communicated with his people through covenants with Abraham and others. Through his saving actions of the Exodus, through the prophets. With time, though, God chose another way to communicate as he sent his Son to us. In the two great mysteries of our faith, the Incarnation, which we celebrate at Christmas, and the resurrection of Easter Sunday, are God's way of communicating with us the depth of his love. We come to know who God is through the life, the death, and the resurrection of his Son, Jesus Christ. During these weeks, we too are needing to find new ways to communicate with one another. We are visiting with people through windows. We are showing respect for one another by keeping our 6 feet distance. We're using FaceTime with family and friends and Zoom to be with coworkers. We experience the Lord in our homes as we pray by ourselves or as a family, making a special place for that prayer. We're making cards for those who are homebound or in nursing homes or other facilities. I even relented and went back onto Facebook. St. Peter, in today's first reading, talks about how God chose us to be witnesses to all that God has done. The apostles and the early disciples were witnesses to Jesus' life, death, and resurrection. And then St. Peter says, God commissioned them to testify to what they have seen and heard. That is also us this Easter Sunday. We are, in a sense, going through a long Good Friday and Holy Saturday during this time. And Good Friday and Holy Saturday, our churches are empty as the Blessed Sacrament, the Eucharist, is removed. If you've seen a picture from the Good Friday from the live stream, or if you remember from last year, the church feels empty without the Eucharist present. And yet, we pray as people who have faith and hope in the love of God. We know that Jesus is not really gone. He is just not as easy to see. We know that we will again see him visibly, just as we will again receive him sacramentally. We are witnesses during these days to the presence of God in our midst. If we have missed not being able to go to Mass, if we have missed receiving the Lord in the Eucharist, that is God being present. Our sadness in not being able to be present and receive him deepens our faith in him. Our desire for Christian community and seeking that online and on relevant radio and in other ways deepens our faith in him. We call the death and resurrection of Jesus the Paschal mystery. That same pattern continues to happen over and over and over again. And it's happening right now in our midst. We have lost Mass and receiving the Eucharist temporarily. But God is changing this experience of loss into a deeper appreciation for the one whom we miss. St. Peter and the others were charged with being witnesses, with testifying to what God has done. We too are charged in a very unique way to be witnesses to our world right now, during these days. As we are going without many things, can we testify to our love of the Eucharist and the Mass as that which we most miss? Can our longing for him and our sharing that desire bring others to deeper faith as well? Can we share with others our experience of how much we desire him? We have a real opportunity now to be people of hope, people who point to God being at work, people who speak out loudly the longing every human heart has for God. This Easter, perhaps more than any other in our lives, we are called to witness to our faith in the risen Lord. We're called to testify to our love for him in the Eucharist, the sacrament in which we remain so close to him. This Easter, as we continue to find ways to connect with one another, let us not be afraid to be like St. Peter. to give witness to the one we love, to testify to the resurrection, and to desire to remain one with him forever. We join now in professing the faith we share. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Knowing that God truly is with us, we bring to the Father our prayers.
For our church, as we share our Easter joy through our witness to God's love in everything that we do, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the courage to live as people of the resurrection, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the gifts of new life, hope, and peace in every nation of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those among us who need caring, healing, or any kind of attention, especially during this pandemic, and for those who minister to them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For every need that is in our hearts, for our deepest yearnings, spoken and unspoken. For all prayers written in our parish book of intentions, and all in need of healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, for Dan Paulson, James Hernandez, Rita Heinrich, Florence King, and for the people of our parish for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And during this year of St. Joseph, we pray this prayer to St. Joseph. Good St. Joseph, as you led the Holy Family, watch over our families. Help our family and all families to know and share God's love. In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God, the Church. With Mary, you raised Jesus, the High Priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good Saint Joseph, pray for us. This time we bring our offerings to the altar of bread and wine. We normally bring our offerings of our lives as well through the collection. Encourage us to continue to remember our parishes with our offerings and to be able to find ways to support them, especially during this time.
Exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise him. He is exalted, forever exalted, and I will praise his name. He is the Lord, forever his truth shall reign. Heaven and earth rejoice in his holy name. He is exalted, the King is exalted on high. He is exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise him. He is exalted forever. Exalted, and I will praise his name. He is the Lord, forever his truth shall be. Heaven and earth rejoice in his holy name. He is exalted. Exalted on high. He is the Lord, forever his truth shall reign. Heaven and earth rejoice in his holy name. He is exalted, the King is exalted on high.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna,
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you the sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Lord Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmos and Dominion, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you also for those to whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, who, though sinners, hope in your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Through him you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving, I'll be a living sanctuary for you. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
As I realize that you are unable to receive the Eucharist, the body and blood of Jesus Christ this morning, I invite you to pause now and make an act of spiritual communion, expressing our desire to receive the Lord. And I will now lead that prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to God who does wondrous things. Let all the people God's praises now sing. All of creation in splendor shall ring. Alleluia. redemption for all has been won. Up from the grave our new life has begun. Life now perfected in Jesus the Son. Alleluia. 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 Now in our presence the Lord will appear. Shine in the faces of all of us here. Us with joy and cast out all our fear. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that, renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Special thanks to all of you for being with us here this Easter morning. I know it's far from how we want to celebrate this great feast of Easter, but it is good to know that you are all with us. During these next 50 days of Easter time, let's become aware of the many times we encounter the presence of the risen Lord among us. See the risen Lord in a child's laughter, in the glory of a sunrise or sunset, in a phone call or an email from a loved one. And most of all, remember the risen Lord is with us when we refuse to let the darkness of these difficult days overwhelm us. Jesus Christ is risen and living among us, always and forever. This is what brings us joy today. And this is what gives us the strength we need to sustain us during this time of crisis. And yes, you can officially say Alleluia now, even if it is still in our trunk at church. We'll take it out when we are all back together, because that will truly be an Alleluia day for all of us.
Just like to extend Easter greetings to all of you joining us on the Facebook stream and any other means. We just want to give you a very personal and warm Easter greetings and Easter blessings on this day as we enter this Easter season. May the joy of the risen Lord be with you and accompany you every single day this year. God bless you.
We're very grateful that Father Matthew and Sister Pam have been able to be with us during Holy Week so that their communities may be here present as we pray together. Just a reminder that our churches are open during the day for prayer. If you'd like to come, continue to visit each of the parish's websites for information about how that happens. We also want to thank all of the people who are praying for each other, who are praying for our parishes, praying for our healthcare workers, praying for those who are sick during this time. Let's continue to keep that up as the body of Christ and keep our witness to the world. A special thanks to our musicians, to Dan and Kathryn this morning, to all of our musicians throughout this Holy Week and throughout our year. We're aware that many of our choir members sing along as they pray with us during these days, and we thank you for making your homes beautiful during this special time. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the prize of immortality. Amen. Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen. Go in peace, alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
See that glowing firmament, knowing.